We're here at the Canelo Media Day. This event going on right now.
It's an exciting moment, Brad. Canelo Alvarez about to be here pretty soon. It's exciting, man.
Is this the biggest turnout you guys ever had?
What was that?
Is it one of the biggest turnouts that you guys ever had?
Yeah, man, it's definitely one of the biggest turnouts. The next one I would say that's pretty close to this was the Canelo Cotto. But definitely the whole Mexican versus Mexican definitely heightens up the energy up
there. What will you be watching the fight?
At my house, man. I'm gonna go to my house in the comfort of my home. You know what I mean? Where I don't have to hear all those so-called boxing experts, so I can watch it comfortable. You know? So yeah, I'm watching it at home.
And how long has Canelo been in your camp?
Well, he's been coming here for his media day workouts. Where I would say maybe the past 4 or 5 fights, I would believe. Yeah. So they're real good friends, real good people, man. Real nice people.
So is it like his good luck charm? Coming here?
I mean, he likes coming, you know. We hold the event for him. We take care of him whenever he comes down. So he keeps coming back. So, hey, you know, we like it here at the House of Boxing.
And my last question to you, do you think that Triple G and Canelo will ever happen?
Yeah, it'll happen. It'll happen. It's just they got to let it build. It's similar to Mayweather Pacquiao. You know, they got to let that thing build. I mean, I think it took Mayweather Pacquiao 5 years to happen. I mean, this is the next big mega fight, so they have to let it build so people can buy into it. So people want to see it, so when it happens, I mean, I'm excited to see that fight. It's a great fight for boxing, so we'll see when it happens.
And tell us where House of Boxing is located.
House of Boxing is located 2336 Happy 2304 Rio Drive here in the community of Paradise Hills of San Diego. Yeah, man, right here, man.
We got a shirt right there. Check it out, y'all. Thank you.
Straight to his interviews.
Okay. And after that?
Straight to the interviews. We'll hop up inside. We'll get wrapped up. And then start doing his mid work. He'll get off. Depending on what he wants to do. We'll do some bag work. We'll do some speed bag or some double end bag. And then that's pretty much it.
How long do you think it'll take? An hour and a half? 30
yeah,
minutes?
Hour and a half.
Oh, okay. Now, out of all these people right here, man, when he walks in, does he see you and be like, hey, man, that's David right there. Let me say what's up to him.
Yeah, he'll say what's up. You know, because, you know, we go periodically to help out at his gym. It's a gym a bit. So, I mean, yeah, he'll say what's up.
All right. We got to hear that howl again.
Oh, yeah, there it is. That's how you do it, baby. House of Boxing.
There you go.
This is on the game.
Canelo, you're fighting a son of a legend. Where are you in the process of becoming a legend yourself?
No, obviamente, desde que empecé este deporte, estoy en el proceso de ser una leyenda desde abajo, desde no tener nada hasta donde estoy. Obviamente, me falta mucho por hacer, pero estoy en el proceso.
Can you translate,
de ser una leyenda.
Yeah, since I've started, I've been building up my legendary status, and I'm still building up my legendary status. You know, it's been since the beginning.
Are you going to shave your beard when you fight, or are you going to keep it?
No. You
guys. can you move back, please? Because we have another media.
Triple G didn't look good his last fight.
and everybody tells me you beat him easy. You agree?
I agree.
A victory in May 6th.
We're here with Canelo Alvarez shadow boxing right now. As you can see, he's warming up, getting ready to go. All that.
Wait.
Look like in great shape. A lot of power. Ready. There you have it, Canelo floating like a butterfly, stinging like a bee right there. Light shadow box.
Bam, 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 bam no, 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 okay. Give me 3 minutes, bro.
Chavez and the best Canelo. So, and I don't know what that is with Chavez. I don't know what the best is that he possesses. You haven't seen it. You've seen the Canelo in great shape, train hard, he's a professional. But I mean, Canelo's going to be better.
Amir Khan, I think a lot of people were saying, oh, he's far bigger than he's going to land that knockout punch.
Right.
Liam Smith, who do we, you know, how do we believe?
Right.
But this fight, clearly, I mean, there are two significant challenges, and all of the challenges in the main way, there's a big test to answer. So,
there's a big test to answer. I mean, the history shows that a smaller champion has never beaten a bigger champion. That's the history of the sport. Right? It just hasn't happened. So, if it happened, it happened once or twice. You know, the bigger guy normally wins, so that's the test that he's going to have to endure.
What's been your take on this whole back and forth between Chavez family and Canelo? Basically, this is a kind of a fight with Chavez Sr. You know, saying Canelo will never be as good as I was. Where do you stand on this whole thing?
Well, look, I mean, you know, obviously I've been very neutral. A fight between Chavez Sr. and Canelo. This is a fight between his son and Canelo, and as much as Chavez can try and defend his son by reminiscing and going back to his career, this is between them too. And it's been very personal for Chavez and Canelo. Obviously, when you're a father, you want to defend your son, but inside the ring, there's nothing he can do. Either Chavez gets knocked out or he wins the fight. That's up to him.
When it gets personal like that, and it got personal between you and the other Chavez, right, when it got to that, do you bring that into the ring with you, or do you just try to set it aside and fight with, you know, to the fight plan?
It's going to be interesting because Chavez's mentality is one where, am I fighting for my father or am I fighting for myself? You know, so, because as a fighter, you're so proud of how hard you worked out, how hard you trained, but yet there's these voices in my ear constantly reminding me that I'm the son of a legend. So that's gonna pan out to be quite interesting. See how it plays out. I don't know how Chavez Jr. is going to walk into the ring thinking and hearing those voices. It's going to be interesting.